which punishment, either real or imagined, sounds light or not a big deal at first, but is actually horrific to experience. Something I actually did to myself. I needed to cut weight for a wrestling tournament in a drastic way. Because of a mix-up in weight classes, I needed to drop 16 pounds overnight. I told my coaches that's not possible. Just pull me from the roster. But my head coach pulls me aside and tells me there might be a way and you don't even have to work out. What you do is fill a bathtub with the hottest water you can stand and add a bag of Epsom salt and some rubbing alcohol to the water. Go into the bathroom with a buddy, stuff towels under the doors so cool air can't get in, and then get in the tub neck deep. After 60 seconds, your body will already be screaming to get out of the water because you're overheating. I stayed in for 45 minutes, adding more hot water every 2 to 3 minutes to ensure that never ended. The buddy is there to make sure you don't die. Sweat out 11 pounds in 45 minutes. Bread and water rations. It was there to cause weaponized constipation. 30 days of constant abdominal pain, specifically tailored to humiliate, is a lot worse than, oh, bland food, boo-hoo. Standing on concrete. Nazis called them Stabunker. Stalin called them Kishka. But it's all the same idea. A cell so small, you are forced to stand because there isn't enough room to sit. Standing barefoot on concrete for days is beyond brutal. It won't kill you, but it will, slowly and very painfully, cripple you while keeping you awake for days straight. Didn't they make them not tall enough to stand upright as well, so you'd be permanently hunched over? Outlawry. To be declared an outlaw. Today, we think of an outlaw as just anybody who breaks the law regularly. Back in the day, though, it was a punishment. If you were declared outlaw, that meant that you were literally outside of the law and could claim no protection from it. If someone didn't like you, they could freely beat you, rob you, torture you, or even kill you. When the stories refer to Robin Hood as an outlaw, that's what they're talking about. It's not a romantic, heroic, swashbuckling thing. It's the state of having no claim to any legal protection at all. The king, or whoever he appoints, takes your land. Anybody who wants it can take your stuff, and anybody who doesn't like you can just beat you to death without consequences. They can also put a bounty on your head and have people hunting you to claim it. What do you think would happen if you lost all protection from the law, and anybody who brought your head to the courthouse could claim a year's salary as a reward? It's like the purge, but just you, having to play with chicken. My grandpa always told me when the neighbor's kids would misbehave 100+ years since then, his parents would lock him into the chicken habitat and put some liquid and or meat on his feet. The chickens would peck at his feet, and he would have to flee constantly until he was too tired to. Then he would be released. Kneeling on grains of uncooked rice. It used to be a common practice in Italy for children to be made to kneel on uncooked chickpeas. In Hungary, corn is used. Goat licking. In medieval times, you would get your feet strapped between two wooden boards and they'd be sprinkled in salt, or similar, so animals, mainly goats, would lick them. Seems like it'd tickle at first, but they won't stop licking. Apparently, they'd lick flesh off until they hit bones. My dad told me about a punishment that was given in schools when he was growing up. Born in 1954, you had to go to the side of the aisle of desks and squat down into, like, the Asian-Russian squat dance, and hold it for the rest of class. He said it never sounded bad, but after a while, your muscles and knees would lock up, and at the end of class, in order to get out of the position, you had to fall onto your side or back to the floor to let your legs relax enough to allow you to move and use them. He told me when I was super young, but it's always stuck with me because I was so surprised that something so seemingly small would cause so much pain and loss of control. You essentially got insane Charlie horses when you dropped out of the position. Getting away with a crime by pleading insanity. Instead of a definite custodial sentence, you get an indefinite custodial sentence in an underfunded and terrifying medical facility, maybe for the rest of your life. Yay! Being ignored or ostracized. It might not sound like much, but as humans, we need that social contact. And leave it too long, and it becomes incredibly damaging. I remember, even as a kid, I got so scared whenever my brother would flat out pretend not to hear me speak or not acknowledge me whenever I was being an annoying little brat. That was a lot more scary to me than anything else. As a person, you want to be remembered, to be at the very least acknowledged. Now imagine that being taken away from you. Tickling. No joke. The Nazis used this as a form of torture in some cases. It doesn't leave a mark. So it's also used in environments like mental facilities, where patients may be restrained and staff go on a power trip. Extreme cases can result in incontinence, vomiting, and a loss of consciousness due to the inability to breathe. It's also easier for the torturer to do it for a long time without it wearing away at their conscience because the victim is involuntarily laughing, so it's easy to pretend that it's not that bad. Listening to the same song on loop, then skipping parts of the song. This was a form of torture used by the CIA, and it's absolutely awful. May I ask what the effects are? Effectively, if a song is played for hours upon hours non-stop with no sign of stopping, you'll get used to it. You'll learn the lyrics, the timing, even minor things like individual drum beats. You begin to normalize it. But if you have the song skip or start over, after 3 days you realize that something happened and that it's not supposed to happen. Your brain got so used to knowing the melody that it effectively tries to send a panic response when something disrupts the song. It would be like seeing an abnormally large bruise come out of nowhere. You'd begin to panic. Since you said imaginary, there is a punishment shown on Star Trek Deep Space Nine that Black Mirror copied a couple of times and science fiction has used as a concept likely before DS9. The concept is time dilation, the idea that time takes place at a different rate in the real world than it does in some other. So for the punishment, the character Miles O'Brien was strapped in a chair for an hour and sedated, and he dreamed he served a 10-year prison sentence. Or maybe it was even longer, but in his mind, he was trapped in the cell for years and years. In the dream, he may have been deprived of food. He was definitely deprived of social interaction, but at the end of it, he woke up and only an hour had passed. Actually, the best Next Generation episode, The Inner Light, played with time dilation as well. Same with the best Voyager episode, Blink of an Eye. There is a short horror manga story called The Long Dream by Junji Ito that has this concept. A man is admitted to a hospital because every night his dreams are longer. Slowly, his dreams become long enough for him to experience an entire lifetime in a single night, only to wake up and barely remember what the reality is. Eventually, the dreams become thousands of years long, and, well, things become very, very horrifying. I highly recommend it. Closing your hand around a chunk of salt water ice and holding it there. Dubbed the Salt and Ice Challenge, where people hold on to it for as long as they can stand, and it can lead to frostbite injuries similar to second and third degree burns. It also essentially fuses to your skin, so if you try to open your hand, it will rip off the skin. You need to use warm water to detach it. I did this about 20 years ago, before it was a thing on social media. It sucks. Standing at parade rest without being able to talk for 5 hours. In basic training, someone got caught stealing food from the DFAC no more than 20 minutes after we had been yelled at for people doing that. As a punishment, we stood at parade rest for 5 p.m. to 10 p.m. without being able to talk and with at least one DS watching us at all times. I don't know how to describe it, but your brain can only come up with so much to do for 5 hours while not moving. Chinese water drop torture. Victims were strapped down so that they could not move, and cold or warm water was then dripped slowly onto a small area of the body, usually the forehead. The forehead was found to be the most suitable point for this form of torture because of its sensitivity. Prisoners could see each drop coming, and after long durations were gradually driven frantic as a perceived hollow would form in the center of the forehead. Kneeling in salt. When I was 16, my mother told me if I kept my attitude up, I'd be kneeling in salt. Being a dumb kid, I was like, oh, whatever, it's just salt. Well, I kept that attitude up. My mom sprinkled a light dusting of salt on the tile floor in the kitchen, and I had to kneel in salt for a half hour. The grains cut my knees and burned the wounds. I'm 32 now, and I still have scars on my knees. Being found not guilty by reason of insanity. No matter the length of sentence you are given, it is up to the doctors to determine when you can be released. A sentence of 10 years in a psychiatric facility could mean 20, 30, or even life. The doctors will only release you when they determine it's safe for you to re-enter society and you are no longer a threat. What doctor is going to release someone and take the chance you'll re-offend? almost none. You'll also be given medications that have terrible side effects. You'll put on a bunch of weight, feel sleepy all the time, dizzy, and eventually develop repetitive movements. You'll be in the general population with other people suffering from severe mental illness, which can drive you crazy in itself. The upside is it may be slightly cleaner than regular prison. You have a little more space to move around the entire unit, even though it's going to be small, and eventually you can earn day passes. Compared to regular prison, it may be a little better overall, but it is still a horrible way to spend your life. It's also incredibly difficult to have this defense apply to your case. So if someone does a crime and thinks they can just plead insanity and be out in 10 years, they are most likely not going to be found insane. Painting rocks. A couple of guys in my AIT unit got in trouble. The sadistic drill sergeant tried being creative with an approved punishment, which was painting rocks. As dumb as a punishment as it is, the sadistic side was that this training unit was in southern Arizona during peak summer temperatures. The rocks were literally hot enough to fry an egg on, and both privates' hands ended up being covered with second-degree burns. The drill sergeant faced pretty heavy administrative action. I don't recall exactly what, but it probably was one of the most severe I had ever heard a drill sergeant receive. And lastly, white room torture. Everything white, tasteless, no sound. Room temperature kept at body temperature, if I remember correctly. Just a bed, toilet, water, and food. Nothing that could be used in any way to alleviate the boredom. It doesn't seem that big at first, just nothing to do for a while, but it's in truth some of the worst torture one can experience. That's the end of the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked this episode, be sure to give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. We'd love to have you. And until next time, see ya.